ओम नमो भगवते नित्यानंदाय। दर्शन ऑफ भगवान टू ए मुल्ला इन मेक्का। व्हेन भगवान नित्यानंद वाज स्टेइंग इन कांजनगार, ए मुल्ला यूज्ड टू विजिट हिम ऑफन एंड टॉक टू हिम। ही हैड एन इंटेंस डिजायर ऑफ विजिटिंग मेक्का एंड मदीना, इस्लामिक पिलग्रिमेज साइट्स। वन डे नित्यानंद भगवान कॉल्ड हिम एंड आस्क्ड, Do you really want to go to Mecca and Medina? Mulla replied with a sigh, Yes, Baba, but don't know when I will have the fortune of going there. Is only the desire of going enough? Don't you need sufficient money for that? Asking so, Bhagavan Nityananda took out money from his lion cloth and gave it to Mulla. The money covered all the expenses of the pilgrimage. It was neither less nor more. Bhagavan had given him the exact amount of money. There was no limit to the happiness of Mulla. When he finally visited Mecca and Medina, Bhagavan Nityananda appeared there too. Mulla realized that Nityananda is not different from Allah. Both are different forms of the supreme divine energy. Mulla remained an ardent devotee of Bhagavan Nityananda until his last breath. Meal with the snake. When Bhagavan Nityananda had been to Kollur, a small temple town in Karnataka, famous for goddess Mukambika temple, he stayed in Kodachadri. Later he stayed in Chitramula for a few days, a place where Shankaracharya had performed penance. A boy named Sadhu Hegde requested Bhagavan Nityananda to come to Someshwar temple in Agumbe. To fulfill Hegde's wish, Bhagavan travelled alone through the dense wild forest of Agumbe and on Shivaratri gave darshan to the devotees in the form of Somashekara. From Agumbe, Bhagavan Nityananda went to Gokarna and stayed near Ram Mandir for a long time. During his stay, there Joglekar, the priest of Mahabaleshwara temple, served him with a lot of dedication and devotion. Joglekar has seen Bhagavan Nityananda having meals with the snake. Was it Lord Shiva in human form who had meals with this most beloved jewel Nagaraj? Stopped a British vehicle in Mastikatte. There is a place called Mastikatte near Ankola in Karnataka. When Bhagavan Nityananda was moving around in the village, a vehicle carrying a British officer approached. Bhagavan signaled with his hand to stop the vehicle. The vehicle didn't stop, however, it couldn't move further after covering a few yards distance as it had violated Bhagavan's order. A mechanic was called to fix the problem, but all the effort was in vain. Neither the British officer nor other passengers in the vehicle knew that the person who asked them to stop was none other than human form of the supreme force which controls all the movement in the universe. Right from the movement of an atom to the movement of gigantic planets. Only when the British officer apologized to the Bhagavan did the vehicle move. Bhagavan had ordered goddess Mahasati to stop the vehicle. He instructed the gathered devotees to construct a temple of Mahasati and proceeded towards Gokarna. Narayan Swami sent to Mastikatte with a desire of having darshan of Bhagavan Nityananda and seeking Atma Vidya under his guidance. Narayan Swami came from Kerala. Shivananda Paramahamsa of Badagara had sent him there saying, You will get Diksha by Bhagavan Nityananda. In Mumbai, Bhagavan Nityananda kicked Narayan Swami with his right foot. Disappointed and dejected, Narayan Swami returned to Kerala and narrated the incident to his guru Shivananda Paramahamsa. Pujya Shivananda Paramahamsa consoled him, telling not to feel bad about it and accept it as Diksha by Bhagavan Nityananda. Narayana Swami went to meet Bhagavan again and stood front of him, bowing his head. Pleased with this persistence and determination, Bhagavan Nityananda asked him to go to Mastikatte and do sadhana. With the blessings of Bhagavan Nityananda, Narayana Swami went to Mastikatte. Getting a single meal in the forest area, inhabited by the local tribe people and Siddis, an ethnic group of descendants of the African Great Lakes region. It was very difficult for Narayana Swami. He went back to Bhagavan Nityananda to share his woes. Nityananda Bhagavan assured him that everything will be taken care and asked him to go back to Mastikatte. Sitting in Ganeshpuri, Bhagavan Nityananda made an arrangement for all the vehicles passing through Mastikatte to stop by the temple and perform puja to Goddess Mahasati before proceeding further. Two more sadhakas joined Narayana Swami and stayed with him in Mastikatte. They started the construction of Nityananda Ashram. In the year 1969, they had to face some hurdles when they wanted to install the idol of Bhagavan Nityananda. One night, Bhagavan Nityananda appeared in the dream of Narayana Swami and said, "Go to Ganeshpuri, meet Karunananda Swami and take him with you to Mastikatte. Everything will be all right." Without wasting any more time, Narayana Swami left to Ganeshpuri. At the time, Mauni Baba Karunananda Swamiji was in deep meditation. Bhagavan Nityananda appeared in the front of him and instructed, "A person will come here to invite you to complete an important work. Go along with him." Mauni Baba Karunananda Swami came to Mastikatte. The construction of the ashram got completed within 6 months, and on 5th February 1971, Vasanta Panchami, the idol of Bhagavan Nityananda was installed amidst the chanting of the mantra Om Namo Bhagavate Nityanandaya. Narayana Swami spent the rest of his life in Mastikatte, continuing his sadhana, meditating of Bhagavan Nityananda and following his teachings. He attained samadhi on 12th July 1996. Nityananda in Gokarna Mahabaleshwara Temple. Once Bhagavan Nityananda went to Mahabaleshwara Temple, a shrine dedicated to Lord Shiva in Gokarna, a popular pilgrimage destination in the state of Karnataka. The head priest was leaving for home after performing puja. "Sadhu, the temple is closed now. You will get darshan of Mahabaleshwara this evening, not before that." Saying so, he left. Bhagavan Nityananda folded his hands and stood on one leg. The bells, kettle drum and gong started ringing on their own. Puja and Arati, a Hindu religion ritual of worship in which light from wicks soaked in ghee is offered to God, was being performed automatically with no human intervention. The priest who was heading towards home stopped in astonishment, hearing the ringing of bells from the temple. The door of the temple was open, which was locked by him just a few seconds ago. He was witnessing a rare puja in his lifetime. Nityananda, who was standing on one leg, appeared as Lord Shiva. The priest fell at the feet of human form of Lord Shiva and begged apologies. After this incident, the people of Gokarna started addressing Nityananda as Bhagavan. Bhagavan Nityananda's miracle in Gokarna. Bhagavan Nityananda is the incarnation of Lord Shiva himself. He has neither a guru nor a disciple. Once a young man came to him with the desire of becoming his disciple. Bhagavan told him, "Okay, if you can eat 5 kilograms of salt, then I will accept you as my student." However, Bhagavan Nityananda has transformed many people as siddhas by guiding them on the path of sadhana. Once Mahabalananda Swami was performing severe penance sitting on a rock in Sanakatte, a village near Gokarna. Only the leaves of the nearby trees were his food. One day he consumed the leaves of poisonous tree. When the poison entered his body, it started burning as hot as a furnace. Mahabalananda Swami started chanting the name of his guru Nityananda, who immediately appeared and showing a place nearby, he told, "Look, there is a stone in front of you. Lift it and you will find water. Drink it soon." When Mahabalananda Swamiji lifted the stone, water gushed out in the form of a fountain. Swamiji drank 2 handfuls of pure water. The poison subsided completely and he was out of danger. The water pond can be still seen in the place An ashram has been built there.
Namo Nityananda.